بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته brothers and sisters welcome back to Shuarauna. Today I have selected for the audience a very beautiful poem that is collected in the great collection of Imam Shafi رحمه الله titled Diwan al-Shafi'i. Imam Shafi رحمه الله he says علي ثياب لو تباع جميعها بفلس لكان الفلس منهن أكثر وفيهن نفس لو تقاس ببعضها نفوس الورى كانت أجل وأكبر وما ضل نصل الصيف إخلاق غمده وما ضل نصل الصيف إخلاق غمده إذا كان عضبا حيث وجهته فرى وإن تكن الأيام أزرت ببزتي فكم من حسام في غلاف تكسر
إذا ما قال لي ربي أما استحييت تعصيني وتخفي الذنب عن خلقي وبالعصيان تأتيني فكيف أجيب يا ويحي ومن ذا سوف يحميني أسلي النفس بالآمان من حين إلى حين.
This is a poem that Imam Shafi rahimahullah he mentions impromptu, right on the spot, because he's a sha'ir, amazing adib this man was, while on his journey from Mecca to Egypt. So he was traveling back to Egypt, and on the way he stopped in a masjid to pray salah. So when he got there, because he was in a journey while he was traveling, so he didn't look, you know, all set and posh. His hair was disheveled, his clothes were old. So he walked in, he prayed salah. Now remember, this is a great imam of Shafi'i rahimahullah in Egypt when he was there, in Mecca when he was there. There's always students around him. People come to him, ask him. He would be sitting from Fajr to Dhuhr, one after the other. People are asking him masail, masail, masail. And now he comes to the masjid with old clothes on and long hair, disheveled hair, and no one pays attention to him. No one values him. And so he walks out of the masjid. He was sort of thinking about this entire scene that just took place. No one said salam to him. No one paid attention to him. So he just starts saying a poem. He says, عَلَيَّ ثِيَابٌ لَوْ تُبَاعُ جَمِيعُهَا بِفَلْسٍ لَكَانَ الْفَلْسُ مِنْهُنَّ أَكْثَرًا. He says, my clothes that I'm wearing and the clothes that are in my entire wardrobe, if they were to be sold, they would be sold for a few pennies, فَلْس, just a few pennies. They're not worth anything. Really, my entire wardrobe is worth few pennies. So he's trying to explain a very important point over here, because when same thing happened when Umar al-Khattab anhu asked Hafsa, his daughter, radha anha, he said, Hafsa, tell me, how many clothes did the Prophet ﷺ have in his wardrobe? And Hafsa, radha anha, said, oh my father, the Prophet had two pairs of clothes. So this is the same thing he's saying here. This is the greatest man to walk on the face of the earth, and he had two simple clothes. Because value and beauty is not defined by our clothes and our external beauty. That Allah doesn't look at that. And it comes in the hadith of the Prophet says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ سُوَرِكُمْ. Allah does not look at our appearances. He doesn't look at what we're wearing, how valuable they are, how expensive our watches. So this is what Imam Shafi'i is saying over here. Then he says the next line, he says, وَفِيهِنَّ نَفْسٌ لَوْ تُقَاسُ بِبَعْضِهَا. But in these clothes, the one who's wearing these clothes, in them there's an inner self, a conscious, that if this nafs and this inner self was to be compared to the inner self of the entire world, my inner self has more value and is more valuable than this inner self of the entire world. Now, he's not claiming to be pious over here, because aspiring to be pious is mandatory, but claiming to be pious is forbidden. But he's trying to define that a person is not beautiful because of his appearance, but rather beauty is determined by his inner self. That's why Ali ibn Abi Talib, he says, لَيْسَ الْجَمَالُ بِأَثْوَابٍ تُزَيِّنُنَا إِنَّ الْجَمَالَ جَمَالُ الْعِلْمِ وَالْأَدَبِ. That beauty is not defined by the clothes a man or a woman wears to adorn themselves. Rather, beauty is the characteristics of a man or a woman. The characteristics is what defines this person as beautiful. لَيْسَ الْيَتِيمَ الَّذِي قَدْ مَاتَ وَالِدُهُ إِنَّ الْيَتِيمَ يَتِيمُ الْعِلْمِ الْأَدَبِ. An orphan is not just an orphan that whose parents have passed away while he was young. Rather, an orphan is also an orphan who does not know any ilm or has no characteristics or adab in his life. That's also a yatim, an orphan in the eyes of Allah, that you could not learn knowledge and you have no adab. So this aspect was Imam Shafi is explaining over here. Once the Prophet ﷺ is sitting there, and the Sahaba see Abdullah bin Mas'ud, a great Sahabi, that a wind blew, and the clothes that he was wearing, it came up, and his calf was exposed. His calf was very skinny. They say that his calf was like a pole, a small little a twig of a tree. And it was very, so people started smiling upon seeing how skinny his calves were. So here's an external thing, and naturally there was a smirk on some of the people's faces who saw this skinny calf of Abdullah bin Mas'ud anhu. The Prophet looks at them and he says, "Are you laughing at the skinniness of his calf?" He said, "Wallahi al-azim, I have seen Allah will make the size of the calf of Abdullah bin Mas'ud on the Day of Judgment in Jannah the size of Mount Uhud. You think it's small, it has no value, but in the eyes of Allah, it has so much value." When the Prophet was sitting there, and Abdurrahman bin Auf and Uthman bin Affan gave so much wealth in the path of Allah, and one Sahabi, he comes and he works all day, all night, and he earns a few dates. So externally, apparently, it looks less than everything else. But the Prophet, he takes these dates, he puts them on his head like this, and he puts them all over all the other wealth that came, and he said, because of these dates, inshallah, Allah will put barakah and everything else. So apparently there were very less, very few, but it's not that. It's not the appearance that matters, it's internal what matters. Look at the Kaaba. Mawlana Rumi talks about this in his Mathnawi. Look at the Kaaba. The Kaaba is a structure of bricks. But how beautiful is it to the person who sees it? The one who's looking at the Kaaba, how much attraction Allah has given to the person, to the Kaaba, to the person who's seeing the Kaaba. Can't get his eyes off the Kaaba, can't get our eyes off the Kaaba. But it's, if you look at it, it's just a structure with bricks. But he said, Allama Rumi talks about how it was the internal ikhlas of Ibrahim, the one, the maker of the Kaaba, that Allah accepted the Kaaba. And when Allah accepted the Kaaba, Allah put the acceptance in the hearts of the people. Now they love it. So we have a society in which we are working so hard to make the apparent things perfect. So weddings, we have weddings that happen. This is a wedding season. And you have weddings, receptions, walimas, that we are preparing for. To the last dot on the eye, we have to make sure everything is perfect. The coloring on the stage, the mic system, the florist, the centerpieces, the chair covers have to be matching, and all this effort is being done so that it looks good. And then when we come to this wedding reception, we have people who are smiling, but they're so broken from inside. So yes, the suit that the person's wearing might be $2,000, but his soul is worth nothing, because this person doesn't know how to meet anybody. This person has no ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You working days and nights and weeks ahead of time for this marriage, but you are missing salah. The bride and the groom were not praying salah, they were not praying tahajjud. So this tells us that this person, our priorities have shifted to make sure everything looks the part. But from inside, we're not putting aces in their places. We're not getting the best bang for our buck. Because when we make ourselves better, Allah puts everything perfect. Even if it looks simple. You know, they say, shadi ko sadi. Take the three dots off of the sheen, it becomes seen. Shadi, sadi. And even if it becomes simple, Allah blesses it. We look at people who are buying homes. MashaAllah, we buy this beautiful home. Externally, we have to make sure the furniture's there, the curtains are matching, everything looks perfect. But this house that Allah made for us to get comfort and joy is no longer giving us comfort and joy. I was in a city recently, and before I had to give a talk there, I gave a survey out to everybody sitting there. And I asked one of the questions I said, what's your excitement level when you get back from work and going home? Like, so when you get in the car and you're going back home on your GPS, you're at home. What's your excitement level? One being not excited at all, and 10, like 10 out of 10 being very excited. How excited are you to go home? And for the most part, people, I said, be very honest with me. How excited you are to go home? And for the most part, people had like 3s, 4s, and 5s. They say, if you can't find joy at home, you can't find joy anywhere else. Why did this happen? Because we forgot that the home, the size of the home or the furniture of the home is not what brings us comfort and joy, but it's the a'mal of the home. Allah's words being recited, the words of the Prophet being recited, salah being prayed, our children sitting up. This is what brings joy and comfort in the house, not all the external part. And this is what Imam Shafi'i alludes to in the next two lines. He says, وَمَا ضَرَّ نَصْلَ الصَّيْفِ إِخْلَاقُ غِمْدِهِ إِذَا كَانَ عَضْبًا حَيْثُ وَجَّهْتَهُ فَرَى. He said, you take a sword, it doesn't matter how dirty the sheath is, how old the cover is. As long as the sword inside is sharp and wherever you point it, it can have an effect and it can damage, then who cares how the cover is? The cover has no effect. You pull it out, it's the same sword. And the opposite is true too. وَإِن تَكُنِ الْأَيَّامُ أَزْرَدْ بِبِزَّتِي فَكَمْ مِنْ حُسَامٍ فِي غِلَافٍ تَكَسَّرَى. He says, but you can have this beautiful cover, you know, worth $10,000, but a broken sword inside, a dull sword inside. You can have this beautiful marriage and wedding reception, but dull souls inside. So it doesn't really make a difference at the end of the day. So he's over here, he's just letting us know that we need to define beauty in a different way. Yes, it's important when I look at my son-in-law or daughter-in-law to see what their education is. Yes, it's important, you know, when we nowadays we do this with even ulama, or scholars will come into our community. How much how many Facebook followers does he have? Instagram, Twitter, and based on those apparent things, we have this acceptance in our heart. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Rubba ash'atha aghbara." Many times there are people who are disheveled hair, aghbar, old clothes, madfu'an bil abwab. People, if they were knocking on someone's door, no one would ever let them inside the house as a guest. لو أقسم على الله لأبرا. Wallahi, if these people asked Allah for something, Allah would have given to them. Allah has hidden two things. Allah has hidden His pleasure in good deeds. So we don't know which good deed makes us what good deed will bring the pleasure of Allah. And the second thing Allah has hidden, Allah has hidden His friends among the general people. So we don't know which one of the people around us is a friend of Allah. And that's why we need to start making an effort on an internal part, just like how we make an external aspect of our life. Yes, it's okay to try to look better and wear good clothes, but just as much as effort we're making externally, we have to make internally. And one way of doing that is, you know that hadith where the Prophet ﷺ, he talks about, he asks, if you had a river flowing in front of you, and you took a shower in there five times a day, would هَلْ يَبْقَى مِنْ دَرَنِهِ شَيْءٍ. Like, would there any speck of dirt be left on this person's body? And the Sahaba said, no way, Ya Rasulullah. No speck of dirt will be left on his body. He says, similar is the case of a person who prays five times Salah. When he prays, this purification Imam Ghazali talks about is the purification of the soul. Slowly Allah will start cleansing our inner self. And Allah will start making ourselves from inside beautiful. And that will resonate. And that is true beauty, not just the beauty of our outer self. Because at the end of the day, anyone that's wearing whatever clothes they're wearing, at the end of the day, when we get put in our grave, we're all going to be wearing the same white shroud. And all of our bodies are going to be rubbing the same dirt. It doesn't really matter at that time. At that time, it matters how valuable our nafs was in the eyes of Allah. Allah says in the Quran, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. On the day of judgment, nothing matters except for that person whose inner self is beautified and perfected and purified. Allah make us among those who make an effort on ourselves and our nafs, and make it pure in the eyes of Allah, and make us among those people who don't judge people just by the appearance or judge a book by its cover. Rather, we treat everyone like a guest of Allah. And if ulama are coming to our gatherings, it doesn't matter what their social media following is, we take from them wherever they are, whoever they are, as long as we can benefit. وَآخُرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنْ حَمْدُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.